As in painting, so in poetry. It was the one term asked by UGC. UGC wanted to give the meaning for the term. Ut pictura. Ut pictura poesy. Ut pictura poesy. And in Ars Poetica, we come to find the term in medias res. And this we come to find in many literary areas. In Milton's dramatic poem, Samson Agonistes. We come to find the term medias res used. So without saying the story of Samson falling in love with Delilah, Milton opens the dramatic play by presenting Samson serving as a slave in Gaza, an eyeless slave in Gaza. We find Samson put as a slave in Gaza. And the earlier story has not been given there. And in fact, the reference is given medias res, that everyone knows the story of Samson Delilah. Samson fell in love with Delilah and he came to Delilah's place. And the Philistines actually blinded him and his hair was shaved off and he lost all his power. He had his power vested in his hair and he lost his hair. And Delilah was the one who made arrangement for shaving the hair and blinding him. And the story is known to the people because this is biblical story. And the play of John Milton entitled Samson Agonistes begins in medias res. Medias res means into the middle of things. And there is another term called abbo, opposite to medias res. Say it is from the beginning. So if a poet wants to describe an unfamiliar thing, he has to begin the story, he has to begin the poem by detailing things from the beginning. This is from the beginning and it is called Abba Ovo. A-B Abba O-V-O-O. And if the story is familiar to the people, there is no necessity to describe the earlier story. The earlier story can be avoided by putting in medias res, saying that the story is known to the people. And there are other popular terms also found in Ars Poetica. For example, there is a popular term called Candoco Bonus Dormitat Homerus. Candoco Bonus. Candoco Bonus. Q-U-A-N-D-O-Q-U-E. Condoco Bonus Dormitat Homerus. H-O-M-E-R-U-S. Homerus. And here we come to find it refers to Homer. It is Homerus. Actually, Homer himself had made mistakes in his writing. Mistake is quite often. Mistake may take place in the writing of a poet. Like Homer nodding with understanding that there is the mistake. The poet has to note his sketch, not to say it is right. The wrong thing should be accepted as wrong. And the poet must show the confidence and the ability and the courage to say that the thing he said was wrong. Like Homer noted his sketch when he understood the mistake. And the term is Candoco Bonus. Candoco Bonus. Dormitat Homerus. And mistakes can even happen in Homer. And when we go into Ars Poetica, we come to find that Ars Poetica is translated into English first by Thomas Drant, D-R-A-N-T, Drant, in 1566. And there is the famous translation made by Ben Jonson in 1640. So Ben Jonson produced Ars Poetica into Art of Poetry. Ars Poetica was called Art of Poetry by Ben Jonson through his translation that took place in 1640. And before him, Thomas Drant produced a translation of Ars Poetica in 1566. Remember that the first translation of Ars Poetica was made into English by Thomas Drant in 1566, and Ben Jonson also produced a translation in 1640, and he changed Ars Poetica into Art of Poetry. And very interestingly, the Romantic poet Byron, Lord Byron, the late Romantic Byron, also produced a translation of Ars Poetica. And many literary people were greatly influenced by Horace for his Ars Poetica. And these are the things that we learned from Ars Poetica. Thank you.